This task is on your corporate digital communication, task 3, December 2019. The topic is on unplanned communications. So while you're doing a lot of work to rebrand, to make changes to your brand identity, keeping a clear view of your employee perception and your employee engagement in that process, the planned activity can be disrupted due to some unplanned communications. And that's the focus of this task. Now, the Van Reel's model on identity and corporate communication management clearly identifies the interface of unplanned communication, connecting the identity and your image. So focus on that and read on this topic of unplanned communications. So unplanned communication can be an employee who's not happy with your rebranding, who could start communicating, and you might have to suddenly respond or take some action on it. It can be a customer. It can be multiple stakeholders who could respond for logical reasons, illogical reasons, or even for malicious reasons. So unplanned communication is our focus. Now, for the start of this task, it's very important to show that you understand the concept of unplanned communications. So defining, for a change, examiner asks you to define what unplanned communication is. So use the right author, not one, maybe use two. And obviously give an example of such an unplanned communication going negative or going positive. So this point on unplanned communication is clearly established. There onwards, it's very important you understand the subject of risk, the subject of reputation risk. So example, if unplanned communication is negative, somebody's already going on social media talking negative about what you're doing, and that's going viral, that's going to impact your reputation. We call it the online reputation in the digital world. Now, when you understand your online reputation impact, you need to go to the basics of this. In other words, you have to understand the risks of your business. In this case, one of the risks are you are changing the identity of the company, and that itself could be a risk. But there are other risks. So you have to understand risks and risk management. And when risks are not managed, it translates into issues. So issues and issue managements. So example, when risks are not managed, issues are not managed. So you need to understand issue management. And this unplanned communication could be such an issue. And when issues are not managed, it becomes a crisis. And if crisis also is not managed, then it totally goes and lands on your overall reputation, and you will see negative results in employee dissatisfactions, in you losing your share price, in your profits over time going down. British Petroleum case is a classic one. There are enough such case studies. You could look at the Volkswagen issue, where they were having significant problems, and Facebook during the Cambridge Analytica crisis had a lot of unplanned communications in the digital space and lost their share price. Of course, over time, they bounced back. So this is your topic. So once again, define the subject of unplanned communications and understand the risks, analyze the risks, a risk assessment of your company, connect those risks into issues and potential unplanned communication situations. So example, if you are making some behavioral changes in your identity, in other words, you are digitalizing your service behaviors like McDonald's is doing with their kiosks, what stakeholders could be impacted by that, especially the employees who might lose their jobs? McDonald's have cut their staff by over 50% in the last maybe half a decade. So there could be disgruntled employees about this. And how could that result in an unplanned communication on social media? And you could analyze such risks, and risks of course has to be profiled based on which are those high risks, lower risks, based on the magnitude of the risk, based on the immediacy, how fast that risk could materialize. So all that theory is available for you, and you need to use that to assess the relevant risks due to an unplanned communication. So that's your task 3.8.